Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon. Friends, today we are going to learn a concept which is known as the current portion of the long-term debt, which is known as CPLTD on the balance sheet side. Well, we are going to look at a graph over here of ExxonMobil, the current portion of the long-term debt, annual, and the non-current portion of the long-term debt. As we move down, what we see is that from 2010 to 2012, there is a tiff between long-term debt and the current and the non-current portion. The current portion of the long-term debt over here is quite high as compared to, or is greater than non-current portion of the long-term debt, as you can see this particular graph and the blue line. Well, no issues. We'll understand this in a detailed format. Let's begin. At the very initial stage, what one needs to understand that, you know, the current portion of the long-term debt, or which is also known as your CPLTD, refers to that portion of the firm's balance sheet that keeps records of the total amount of the long-term debt, and that must be paid within the ongoing period or the ongoing year. So what you can see, the chart over here of the ExxonMobil, it tracks the current portion of the long-term debt versus the non-current portion of the long-term debt of Exxon for the past 5 years. So we note that during the 2016 time period, the ExxonMobil had 13.6 billion, as you can see, of the current portion of the long-term debt, as compared to 28.39 of the non-current portion. However, in the year of 2013 and 14, Exxon's current portion of the long-term debt was far greater. Look at this particular portion. It was far more greater than that of the non-current portion. Now, my question is that, is this good or bad for Exxon? So, no, in this particular tutorial, we are going to discuss the current portion of the long-term debt, or what you call as CPLTD, and answer the question that I've asked. Now, what is the current portion of the long-term debt? That's the first thing you need to understand. See, debt is the obligation because it is borrowed by one party from another. So the one who takes the loan is the debtor, and from whom the loan is taken is called the lender or the creditor. Right. So the organization or the corporates uses this debt for making large purchases, like such as for the plants, building, facilities, and so on and so forth. Now, that these firms cannot afford in the normal circumstances. Moreover, if you see, the debt is the only cheapest. No, I'm wrong. Not the only. It is one of the cheapest form of available to the firms and corporates for long-term financing, because it provides an option to the borrower to pay it back a later date with, we shouldn't forget this, its interest. However, the long-term debts, you know, has multiple forms, includes, like, you know, bonds, they have debentures, secured notes, mortgages, notes, and loans taken from the banks and financial institutions. So from the company's point of view, the long-term debt means that, you know, any financial obligation, any financial obligations which are lined up for a period which is greater than 12 months. Is greater than 12 months. So, however, the company often pays a portion of this long-term obligations or liabilities within the current or ongoing year, so which is known as your current portion of long-term debt, right? Now, there's this company called Seadrill. Seadrill Limited, the current portion of the long-term debt. This is the extract of the company of Seadrill Limited. Seadrill Limited is registered in or listed in NYSE stock exchange, has a long-term debt standing at closely to $9 billion, $9.8 billion, and is expected to pay $3.1 billion in the current year. You can see the amount, and hence it is recorded as a 6.6 billion as a long-term debt and 3.1 billion as a current portion of the long-term debt at the end of the fourth quarter of 2016. So as observed, you know, Seadrill balance sheet does not paint a good picture, because its current portion of the long-term debt has increased by, you can see, from 1489 to 3195. That's closely to 110% or 15% on YOY basis. It is because, you know, Seadrill does not have sufficient liquidity. It's cash liquidity to cover its short-term borrowings, right, and the current liabilities. In other words, Seadrill has high amount of the current portion of the, you can say, the long-term debt as compared to the liquidity such as cash and cash equivalents. And this suggests that, you know, Seadrill will find it difficult to make its payment and pay off its short-term obligations. Now, as you can see in this particular graph of Seadrill current portion, as a you know, the thumb rule states that, you know, a company with a high number of the current portion of the long-term debt as compared to the small cash positions has a higher risk of default. As you can see, the Seadrill's current portion of the long-term debt and the Seadrill's non-current portion of the long-term debt, the data is right in front of you. We have the graph, and you know, same goes with the Seadrill because they have a high number of its current portion of the long-term debt and comparatively a low cash in that scenario. As a result, you know, the higher CPLD the company have was on an average of defaulting. And accordingly to Simply Wall Street, Seadrill proposed a debt restructuring plan to survive the industry downturn. As for the scheme, the company plans to basically renegotiate. Renegotiate what exactly? They worked on the plan of its borrowing with the creditors and also has a plan to defer most of its current portion of the long-term debt. But that's what was the term that was being placed on in front of the meeting. However, this move had negative impact on its share price performance because the company saw its share price plunging down or falling more than 15% last month. And in fact, this was the second announcement regarding its debt restructuring, as the company was not able to please the creditors as per its earlier given debt that was closely to 30th December 2016. So this time the company, you know, pushed its deadline at the end of April 2017. Right. So in the case of the Seadrill, the company is not able to pay its current portion of its long-term debt due to its historical weakness. You can see that historical weakness in the crude oil sector and poor market conditions. Like, for instance, the crude oil prices fell more than 50% since the high of 100 per barrel closely to 100 per barrel in 2014. To close around, it closed around 50 per barrel at present due to the oversupply of the crude oil and, you know, increases in the inventory in the United States. So this were the circumstances, they know, that led to, you know, a turmoil situation, a crash crunch situation where the Seadrill Limited had to actually survive. Now, you know, how to get to know if the company is risky in the investment? Well, you can analyze some of the ratios like the current ratio. You can also use some of the ratios like debt to equity ratio. Then you can also use liquidity ratio, because that will also be helpful in your case for this particular ratio, for this particular thing. So on an overall note, we have concluded in a really great fashion. We have learned about this particular topic. So debt is, we can say, the important composition of the company's total capital, because it creates a financial leverage which can multiply the returns of the investment, provided the return derived from the loans exceeds or is greater than the cost of loan or debt, basically. However, it all depends on the company, because if the company is utilizing the debt taken from the bank or the other financial institution in a right manner, meanwhile, the current portion of the term debt should be treated as, you know, the current liquidity, as it represents, you know, the principal part of the debt payments. So as a result, the company's financial positions, you know, sometimes becomes risky, which is not encouraging sign for the investors and lenders. So this ratio should be really in a maintained situation.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.